Hello students, welcome back. Let's continue with exercise 9C, 8th standard, 8th problem. Rekha borrowed rupees 40,000. P is equal to rupees 40,000 for 3 years. Time is equal to 3 years at 10% per annum compound interest. Rate is equal to 10%. Calculate the interest paid by her for the second year. For first year, the interest is equal to P T for 1 year. Let's calculate for 1 year. R upon 100. 4000. Rupees 4000 is the interest for the first year. When we add this interest to the principal, this becomes 44,000. That is the amount. This amount becomes the principal for the second year. 44,000 P T R upon 100. 4,400. Rupees 4,400 is the interest for the second year. Ninth problem, calculate the compound interest for the second year on rupees 15,000. P is equal to rupees 15,000 invested for 5 years at 6% per annum. Rate is equal to 6% per annum. We have to calculate the compound interest for the second year. For first year, the interest is equal to P T R upon 100. This is 900. Rupees 900 is the interest for the first year. Amount is 15,900. Interest plus the principal. Amount is equal to rupees 15,900. This becomes the principal for the second year. So interest is equal to 15,900 into T R upon 100. 159 into 6. 6 9 is 54, 5 remains. 6 5 is 30, 35, 3 remains. 6 1 is 6, 9. So interest for the second year is equal to rupees 954. 10th problem, a man invests rupees 9600. P is equal to rupees 9600 at 10% per annum. Rate is equal to 10% per annum compound interest for 3 years. Calculate the interest for the first year. Interest for the first year is equal to P T 1 year R upon 100. 96 into 10 is equal to rupees 960. This is the interest for the first year. The amount at the end of the first year. Amount at the end of the first year is equal to 9600 plus 960. Rupees 10,560 is the amount at the end of the first year. Now third, the interest for the second year. Interest for the second year is, now this becomes a P. P is equal to 10,560 rupees. So interest is equal to P T R upon 100. 00 goes off. 1056 remains. Therefore, interest for the second year is equal to rupees 1056. Now the amount is equal to 10,560 plus 1056. 11,616. Amount is equal to rupees 11,616. This becomes the principal for the third year. Let us calculate the interest for the third year now. For third year, the principal is equal to 11,616. Therefore, interest is equal to P T R upon 100. 11,616 divided by 10 is equal to 1161.6. 1,161.6 rupees. This is the interest. Interest for the third year. 11th problem. A person invests rupees 5000 for 2 years. Principal is equal to rupees 5000 for 2 years. Time is equal to 2 years. At a certain rate of interest compounded annually. At the end of 1 year, this sum amounts to rupees 5600. Amount is equal to rupees 5600. Calculate the rate of interest per annum. Rate is equal to SI into 100 upon P into T. Now SI is equal to A minus P. A is equal to 5600 minus P is equal to 5000. Therefore SI is equal to 600 rupees. So SI 600 into 100, P is equal to 5000, time is equal to 1 year. 60 divided by 5 is equal to 12. Rate is equal to 12%. Now we have to calculate the amount at the end of the second year. For that we have to find the interest of the second year. Now the principal is equal to 5600. Amount of the first year becomes the principal for the second year. So interest is equal to P into R. That is 12 into time for 1 year upon 100. 56 into 12. Rupees 672. This is the interest for the second year. Therefore the amount is equal to P plus interest. P is equal to 5600 plus interest is equal to 672. That is equal to, therefore amount at the end of second year is equal to rupees 6272.